Hi, my name is Sophia Ervin, and this is just going to be a brief political reflections of director Fritz Lang's films, a couple of them. It brings a smile when a show like CSI references the date of the original air date of the show. It kind of pulls you in. And many of today's audience members kind of get a chuckle when writers choose to characterize the current president of the United States or political injustices in television and cinematic mediums. I've lived long enough to see movies remade, and I can remember joking with my high school buddies that we would be taking our grandchildren to see Halloween and Friday the 13th. While we don't have grandchildren, Friday the 13th and Halloween are still around. But it never dawned on me to go back and watch the original movies. You know what I mean, the black and whites, those that were made during the silent eras and those that they call the talkies. My thoughts about silent films and the talkies was this. They were just black and white, overacted, boring, and they want me to read comedies of sorts. But after taking a drama class, I was introduced to a director, Mr. Fritz Lang. In his own right, Fritz is the originator and the innovator of many cinematic firsts that have been replicated and referenced many times over. It's important to illustrate how brave a man that Mr. Lang was in taking a stand cinematically against Hitler and the Nazis.
Their right-wing views appealed to the disillusioned private. He decided to join the party. He later said, "It was the most decisive resolve of my life. From here, there could be no turning back." Almost immediately, he took an active role in the party, and by July 1921, he was their leader. Its support was growing steadily, and it was renamed the National Socialist German Workers' Party, or Nazis for short. The symbol for the party was chosen by Hitler himself. The swastika was an ancient symbol that Hitler had redesigned for his own needs.
The first film that I highly recommend to watch is Metropolis. This movie commands respect today for Fritz and his team's innovative way of creating a futuristic world and the first cinematic android. Metropolis was released in 1927. This was just a few years after Hitler had been in prison for staging a coup, and 1 year after Hitler released the second volume of Mein Kampf. There are many reasons and many scenes in Metropolis that reflect the ease in which charisma can whip the common man and even the well-off man into mass mob actions, which are horrific to those viewing outside of the enchantment. In 1927, Hitler was expanding his following and pushing his nationalist German and anti-Semitic ideas. Metropolis had the foresight to illustrate how a compelling, delusional leader could enable the common man caught in his dreary, poverty-ridden, day-to-day life to make insane decisions which would unknowingly lead to the demise of their own children. As the Nazis continued to increase in political power, Fritz, dubbed the Master of Darkness by the British Film Institute, continued to produce films from different genres. The next film that I recommend is M. In 1931, the Nazis had tried to shut down the production of the film and even threatened Lang's life when M was released. By 1933, Adolf Hitler had come into full power and the Nazis banned Lang's next film, The Testament of Dr. Mabuse, citing it as an incitement to public disorder. Lang feared that his Jewish heritage, his mother, a Jewish woman who had converted to Catholicism, would be added cause for his demise by the hands of the Nazis. Lang's own wife, Thea von Harbo, sympathized with the Nazis and joined the party in 1932. They soon divorced, and Lang emigrated from Austria and eventually landed in Hollywood. The leading reason why M was outlawed by the Nazis is because they thought that the movie was about them. The original title, Murderers Among Us, was what led them to believe that Fritz was trying to incite the public against the Nazi Party. It was clear that Lang used his art to convey his beliefs, both in sympathy for the mentally challenged, sympathy against the death penalty, and the destructiveness of groupthink, led by a captivating leader and fueled by thugs. Brilliantly illustrates the outcome of the psychologically unstable man as the centerpiece which fuels and drives citywide and even national sentiment. It is shown with overshadowing impending doom both for the victims and the central character. The exploitable citizen's need to return to normalcy and safety is subversively supported by a congealed self-preserving sentiment among the criminal element in the town. The vigilante drive of groupthink is taken right to the edge of its murderous outcome during a mock trial. M clearly showed that thug justice is unmerciful. And as history records, the groupthink of the Nazis led to World War II and the torture and mass murder of millions. Fritz Lang, a gifted and talented screenwriter, cinematic innovator, master storyteller and illustrator, advocate against political psychosis. I strongly recommend M and Metropolis just for the enjoyment of the circus stories that they represent. While watching, you may begin to recognize how many modern day movies pay tribute to these masterpieces. Hopefully, this extremely brief history gives you the background to appreciate a man who demonstrated not only how to be at the top of his game, but also understood the consequences of the responsibility that his platform allowed to speak out.